Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Anju Yadav and today I am going to review a movie, The Book of Ellie 2. It is an amazing movie, so hope you guys are like it and enjoying it. If you guys like it, then don't forget to subscribe our channel and let us know in a comment section how this review is. So through this video, I wanted to tell that how much has been invested in this film, how much has been earned from this film, and the most important thing, how many actors and actresses are there in this film, what are the story of this film. And through this video, I wanted to clear one more thing, is that many people feel that it is a complete movie, but not so it is, guys, because it is a complete review and fact. So I will tell you now and I will tell you that it is a complete review and fact. If you guys like it, then don't forget to subscribe our channel and let us know in a comment section how this movie review is. So thank you very much for joining us. Now let's start a movie review. So hope you guys are like it and enjoying it. So now let's start a movie review, The Book of Ellie 2. It is an amazing movie. So hope you guys are like it and enjoying it. So now let's start a review. The Book of Ellie 2 is a 2024 American post-apocalyptic neo-western action film directed by Hughes Brothers, written by Gary Vitta, and starring Denzel Washington, Gary Oldman, Mila Kunis, Ray Stevenson, and Jennifer Bills. The story revolves around Ellie, a gnome in a post-apocalyptic world who seeks to deliver his copy of a mysterious book to a safe location on the west coast of the United States. Filming began in February and took place in New Mexico. The Book of Ellie 2 was released theoretically in 2024. By Warner Bros. Pictures. It received mixed review from critic, but at the worldwide box office and one budget of $80 million. And The Book of Ellie 2 was a big hit when it was released, and there is still a question of whether there will be a Book of Ellie 2. Though the movie failed to impress most critics, the post-apocalyptic neo-western was still praiseworthy for its unique take on the genre. The Book of Ellie also fared well at the box office and managed to gross over $150 million via Box Office Mojo. Thanks to the star power of Denzel Washington in the lead role, as is usually in case with the blockbuster movies, speculation regarding a sequel to The Book of Ellie started up almost immediately after its release, with the hope that viewers would get to see more of the post-apocalyptic landscape. With similar movies like Mad Max blooming into full-fledged franchise, the idea of an extended universe for The Book of Ellie isn't entirely out of this question. However, with so much time passed since the original release, the chance of a Book of Ellie 2 grown similar and similar with each year. What really fanned the flames of a potential sequel to The Book of Ellie 2 was the character evolution of Solara, played by Mila Kunis. While she started off teamed as unsure, Solara had seemingly replaced Ellie following his death at the end of The Book of Ellie, and her decision to leave the sanctuary of Altrakares Island obviously means she had unfinished business in her hometown. Solara would be a perfect character to lead a sequel, and the possibility to expand the universe of the first film could be found in her adventure. Speaking with Hindustan Times, Kunis denied any chance of a Book of Ellie follow-up when she said, "I don't think there should be a sequel. I think the purpose of the story ends. It's done considering the fact that the story could only really continue with the Solara. The chance of the Book of Ellie 2 are essentially none without Kunis on board. A recast would completely rob as a sequel of its power, even if it died up some of the loose ends from the first film. With so many years between release, The Book of Ellie 2 would have been nearly perfect to be successed." Another big reason why The Book of Ellie 2 is highly unlikely is that the ending of the original film wrap up the story concisely. While it doesn't explicitly explain everything, the ending of the Book of Eli is strong enough to finish the story and a powerful note with nothing else needed to complete the experience. Solar character change was the perfect way to send the audience home happy, but it did not necessarily warrant a sequel. Furthermore, Eli's blindness twist was also a satisfying surprise to cap off the story. With the title character dying triumphantly after completing his mission, the main message of the Book of Eli had been fulfilled. Eli successfully delivered the Bible into the hands of Lombardi, though his memory. And it's clear the Carnegie power has slipped and his empire has crumbled since science fiction films rarely get a definitive ending. The Book of Eli and potential Book of Eli 2 would only serve to harm its legacy. And I'm at least loss of four words, so let me say these right away. The Book of Eli is very watchable. You won't be sorry you went. It grips your attention and then at the end throw it a several WTF moments, which are a bonus. They make everything in the entire movie impossible and incomparable, but they were WFT. Now the words I am at loss for. The story involved a lone wanderer, Daniel Washington, who wear a name tag saying, "Hi, my name is Eli." It may not actually be his name tag, but let's call him Eli. Anyway, Eli has been walking west across the devastated landscape of America for 30 years. On his way to the sea, I haven't walked it myself, but I'm pretty sure it doesn't take that long. On the other hand, maybe Eli only thought that he was walking west. On his final trek, he walked from right to left across the screen, which in movie shorthand is walking east. "How do you know you are walking the right way?" isn't asked. "Faith," he says, reply that task on added resonance later in the film. Ellie's quick hand with the knives, pistols, rifles, shotguns and carrot. He need to be after a catastrophe has wiped out most of the Earth's population and left ruin and desolation behind. The remaining human are victimized by roaming motorcycle gang of hijackers and thieves. Each of these gangs is issued a requisite tall bald man, a short hairy scruffy one of their gophers. The hugest brother Albert and Alan film this story is summered brown and pale blues, creating a dry and dusty world under a merciless sky. Water is treasure. This wasteland, Eli trek at the impeccable peace set upon in ambush. She kills his attackers. He's got one of those knives that make a snake snack noise all by itself. And it's one of man army who don't the bad guy just shoot at him. Later in the film, they try that. Washington and the hugest brother do a good job of establishing this man and his world. And at first, the Book of Eli seems destined to be soul man, but then Eli arrive at Western town ruled by Kanji, who, like all the local overlords in Western and gangster movie, sit behind a big desk flanked by a tall, bold guy and, of course, a short, scruffy one. How are these guys recruited? Wanted tall bird guy to stand behind town boss and be willing to sacrifice life. All the water you can drink. In this town, dispirited and starving people live in rusty car and in the streets. We met Karinej's abused wife, Colidia Jennifer Beals, and her daughter, Solara Mila Kunis, named for some reason. After the cause of all the destruction, she's prostitute in Carnage Bar, having made the mistake of coming in on a tank your child to work day. Carnage hurled Claudia to control Solara. How he controlled the fearsome bold guy is hard to say. The third act is recycled but done well. Out of many western in which the hero and the girl hole up and surrounded, so many other movie are referenced that we almost miss it. When their hideout house is portrayed by bullets in LA confidential style that allow countless beam of sunlight to shine in and function as metaphor, Carnage needs Ellie because Ellie has maybe the last remaining copy of a book that Ellie believes will allow him to expand and rule many more towns. I'm forbidden by the critic little rule book from mentioning the value, but if you have made a guess after seeing numerous billboards stating religion is a power, you may have guessed right. The hugest brother have a vivid by way the imaginary here isn't their earliest films such as Mancy, Second Society and the unrated form Hell. The film looks and feel good and the Washington's performance is the more uncanny, the more we think black over it, the ending is fluid as we critic like to say, but it's so imagination is seamlessly impossible fluid that it's break apart from the movie and has a life of its own, or at least it's avoid being predictable. So hope you guys are like it and enjoying it. If you guys like it, then don't forget to subscribe our channel and let us know in a comment section how this movie is. The ending of 2010 post-apocalyptic action movie The Book of Alice stepped in deeper meaning and the features a shocking twist. The Book of Ellie followed Denzel Washington as the titular Ellie, a Rudge survivor traversing a post-apocalyptic wasteland in a possession of a mysterious book that it's quickly apparent many are willing to kill for. Though the average critical response was a negative, some praised the Book of Ellie gripping plot and exciting twist on the post-apocalyptic genre. Even among a wealth of other films tackling the same subject, The Book of Ellie managed to world build in a way that is constantly compelling, and the movie grossed over $150 million by a box office mojo. The Book of Ellie surprises viewer with the bounty of twist while never returning its back on the strong use of symbolism that carried throughout the plot. This heavy thematic depth also means the Book of Ellie ending leave plenty to unpack a fact responsible for its cult successor over a decade after its default. After securing the book, which is revealed to be an intact copy of the Bible at the ending of the Book of Ellie, the evil Bill Carnage Gary Oldman returned to his town and enlisted the help of engineer Tom Waits to break the lock that's hold it closed. Meanwhile, Ellie and Solara arrive in the remains of San Francisco and row out of Alcatraz Island, where they are greeted by Lombardi McCollum M.D. Well and his people, who are working to preserve the sum of human knowledge that came before the nuclear holocaust that wiped out civilization. Carnegie managed to get Eel's Bible open only to discover that it was written in Braille and there is no way he can read it. Though he loses the Bible in the fight with Carnage, Ellie remembers his entire consent by heart and can recount the words to Lombardi, who engagedly being writing everything down. Back in town, Carnegie is confronted by Claudia, who refused to translate the Braille for him and alerts him that his quest to secure the book has led him to lose control of his city. After recounting the Bible in its entirety, Ellie eventually dies and the freshly printed Bible is placed among the shelf full of other holy books. In the final scenes of The Book of Ellie, Solara opts not to stay at the Alta Cruz sanctuary and takes Ellie's sword as she returns home across the wasteland. Though The Book of Ellie gave very little indication that Ellie cannot see, it nevertheless pulls a shocking twist by revealing that he is blind. One of the things that make The Book of Ellie an unrated 2010 sci-fi movie is that it's continued to push its concept further and further, and Ellie's blindness is just a meaningless twist. Brilliantly revealed in the scenes where Carnegie discovered the Bible isn't Braille, the twist ending came about slowly as opposed to being movement that overemphasized itself, and it's completely changed The Book of Ellie's story. Unlike many other movie twists that make us rewatch unnecessarily, the reveal of Ellie's blindness makes The Book of Ellie more compelling experience as on second viewing. Ellie's blindness also makes him more dynamic because his very existence becomes symbolic. Throughout the movie, Ali exposes the power and importance of faith, and though he never uses the exact word, faith has always been described as a blind belief. Ali is the living embodiment of faith because he allowed himself to be led by the higher power, an adventure that would normally be impossible for someone who is visually impaired. Action movies where the main character dies are rare, but The Book of Ali ending is made better because Ali doesn't survive. Instead of giving him all the guns blazing final that would have tipped the movie into Sealer's territory, Ali's mode and stubble that is appropriate for a character who is an action horror hero by choice. Ali's death, the end of The Book of Ali, is almost necessity because it's reflect element of the Bible and the many other figure who also met their ends in pursuit of faith. The gunshot wounds Ali suffered from carnage earlier in the movie led to his death, but not before he can impart his knowledge of the Bible to Lombardi. Having made the ultimate sacrifice, Ali tried his life to protect the religion he holds dear, and he married Christine and Mysterious, who would later become saints in some dimensions. The power of sacrifice is one of the central tenets of the most religions, but it's especially important in Christianity when considering the story of Jesus and his death in the New Testament, something the hero journey in the Book of Ali mirrors. Despite not being a critical success, The Book of Ali is anything but a disposable blockbuster with no substance. Nearly every aspect of the story serves more larger purpose in the grand scheme of things, and the plot is rich with meaning. The Book of Ali 2 makes it clear in the end of the Christianity isn't the sole specific message that is to be taken away from the story, because the newly printed Bible take its place among other holy books. Instead, the Book of Ali is ultimately about the power of ideas and it's how they can be divided for goods and bad purpose. Carnage wanted to use the Bible as a means of controlling the minds of those around him, while Lombardi and Ali were keepers of knowledge who only wanted to benefit humanity. Ironically, Ali cryptically suggests in the voiceover that the apocalyptic war was fought over religion, which makes his mission all the more imperative. In the end, The Book of Ali doesn't endorse a religion over another, but instead warn of the power of such powerful belief and shows how they can be intense good as well and unfathomable evil that can spring from the very same well of ideas. The Book of Ali 2 has been a cult success as far as post-apocalyptic movies go, with many fans hoping for the sequel 3 also. While there are currently no plans for The Book of Ali 3, there is another project that will extend the manifesting story. A Book of Ali prequel series starring John Boyega is currently in development, with the screenwriter Gary Whitta set to return. The Book of Ali prequel shown in still in the development with the studio Alcon Television Entertainment behind the project. It's currently unknown which network or streaming service is the series will arrive on, as it's currently being shopped or various different potential buyers. The source was announced in January 2024, and new has been scarce in the time since. While there are very few details, it is known that the Whitta plans and Boyega's to star as a younger version of Ali. Given the time frame of the 2010s movie, it is entirely impossible that the show will include the apocalypse that occurred before The Book of Ali being shown. How the character in the movie become the heroes and villains seen in the original film, there is also a chance, of course, that is a prequel series in a success that Book of Ali 2 could. And as soon as you hear the title, you can probably guess is what kind of film The Book of Ali 2 is going to be. Yes, it is the story about a man named Ali and who is alone. One of the films who has a book, it's also about the Bible, which is the case, seems to provide not a set of belief but simply the hope that humanity has a future. The film play out in a post-apocalyptic wasteland that will look familiar to fans of the Mad Max trilogy. Like the protagonist in those films, Ali must fight off a slew of lenses killer thieves and rapists who will, like Ellie, have solved the nuclear holocaust that occurred 30 years earlier. Ellie's mission gave to him by a voice in his head is to move west in the book, which is supposedly the last copy of Earth. And the themes of the film doesn't explore as deeply as it might. The Book of Ellie 2 is an old-fashioned western dressed up in the protagonist rag. Ellie is the main with no name who assembled into backwater bug in search of water, came to face-to-face with the evil in a form of carnage. So, Newbell daughter Solara Milaken is the real some illusion here to be the biblical story of hero and his daughter. The Book of Ellie 2 is a 2024 American post-apocalyptic neo-western action film directed by Hughes Brothers, written by Gary Vitta and starring Denzel Washington, Gary Oldman, Mila Kunis, Ray Stevenson and Jennifer Bills. The story revolves around Ellie, a gnome in a post-apocalyptic world who seeks to deliver his copy of a mysterious book to a safe location on the west coast of the United States. Filming began in February and took place in New Mexico. The Book of Ellie 2 was released theoretically in 2024. By Warner Bros. Pictures. It received mixed review from critic, but at the worldwide box office and won budget of $80 million. And the Book of Ellie 2 was a big hit when it was released, and there is still a question of whether there will be a Book of Ellie 2. Though the movie failed to impress most critics, the post-apocalyptic neo-western was still praiseworthy for its unique take on the genre. The Book of Ellie also fared well at the box office and managed to gross over $150 million via Box Office Mojo. Thanks to the star power of Denzel Washington in the lead role, as is usually in case with the blockbuster movies, speculation regarding a sequel to The Book of Ellie started up almost immediately after its release, with the hope that viewers would get to see more of the post-apocalyptic landscape. With similar movies like Mad Max blooming into full-fledged franchise, the idea of an extended universe for the Book of Ellie isn't entirely out of this question. However, with so much time passed since the original release, the chance of a Book of Ellie 2 grown similar and similar with each year. What really fanned the flames of a potential sequel to The Book of Ellie 2 was the character evolution of Solara, played by Mila Kunis. While she started off teamed as unsure, Solara had seemingly replaced Ellie following his death at the end of The Book of Ellie, and her decision to leave the sanctuary of Alcatraz Island obviously means she had unfinished business in her hometown. Solara would be a perfect character to lead a sequel, and the possibility to expand the universe of the first film could be found in her adventure. Speaking with Hindustan Times, Kunis denied any chance of a Book of Ellie follow-up when she said, "I don't think there should be a sequel. I think the purpose of the story ends. It's done considering the fact that the story could only really continue with the Solara. The chance of the Book of Ellie 2 are essentially none without Kunis on board. A recast would completely rob as a sequel of its power, even if it died up some of the loose ends from the first film. With so many years between release, The Book of Ellie 2 would have been nearly perfect to be successed." Another big reason why The Book of Ellie 2 is highly unlikely is that the ending of the original film wrap up the story concisely. While it doesn't explicitly explain everything, the ending of The Book of Ellie is strong enough to finish the story and a powerful note with nothing else needed to complete the experience. Solar character change was the perfect way to send the audience home happy, but it did not necessarily warrant a sequel. Furthermore, Ellie's blindness twist was also a satisfying surprise to cape up the story, with the title character dying triumphantly after completing his mission. The main message of the Book of Eli had been fulfilled. Eli successfully delivered the Bible into the hands of Lombardi, though his memory. And it's clear the Carnegie power has slipped and his empire has crumbled, since science fiction films rarely get a definitive and ending. The Book of Eli and potential Book of Eli 2 would only serve to harm its legacy. And I'm at least loss of four words, so let me say these right away. The Book of Eli is very watchable. You won't be sorry you went. It grips your attention and then at the end throw it a several WTF moments, which are a bonus. They make everything in the entire movie impossible and incomparable, but they were WFT. Now the words I am at loss for. The story involved a lone wanderer, Daniel Washington, who wear a name tag saying, "Hi, my name is Eli." It may not actually be his name tag, but let's call him Eli. Anyway, Eli has been walking west across the devastated landscape of America for 30 years. On his way to the sea, I haven't walked it myself, but I'm pretty sure it doesn't take that long. On the other hand, maybe Eli only thought that he was walking west. On his final trek, he walked from right to left across the screen, which in movie shorthand is walking east. "How do you know you are walking the right way?" isn't asked. "Faith," he says, reply that task on added reasons later in the film. Ellie's quick hand with the knives, pistols, rifles, shotguns and carrot. He need to be, after a catastrophe has wiped out most of the Earth's population and left ruin and desolation behind. The remaining human are victimized by roaming motorcycle gang of hijackers and thieves. Each of these gangs is issued a requisite tall bald man, a short hairy scruffy one of their gophers. The Hughes brother Albert and Alan filmed this story is summered brown and pale blues, creating a dry and dusty world under a merciless sky. Water is treasure. This wasteland, Eli trek at the impeccable peace set upon in ambush. She kills his attackers. He's got one of those knives that make a snake snack noise all by itself. And it's one of man army who don't the bad guy just shoot at him. Later in the film, they try that. Washington and the Hughes brother do a good job of establishing this man and his world. And at first, the Book of Eli seems destined to be soul man. But then Eli arrives at Western Town, ruled by Kanji, who, like all the local overlords in Western and gangster movie, sit behind a big desk flanked by a tall, bold guy and, of course, a short, scruffy one. How are these guys recruited? Wanted tall bird guy to stand behind town boss and be willing to sacrifice life. All the water you can drink. In this town, dispirited and starving people live in rusty car, and in the streets we met Karinage, abused wife Collidia, Jennifer Beals, and her daughter Solara Mila Kunis, named for some reason. After the cause of all the destruction, she's prostitute in Carnage Bar, having made the mistake of coming in on a tank your child to work day. Carnage hurled Claudia to control Solara. How he controlled the fearsome bold guy is hard to say. The third act is recycled but done well. Out of many western in which the hero and the girl hole up and surrounded, so many other movie are referenced that we almost miss it. When their hideout house is portrayed by bullets in LA confidential style that allow countless beam of sunlight to shine in and function as metaphor. Carnage needs Eli because Eli has maybe the last remaining copy of a book that Eli believes will allow him to expand and rule many more towns. I'm forbidden by the critic little rule book from mentioning the value, but if you have made a guess after seeing numerous billboards stating religion is a power, you may have guessed right. The hugest brother have a vivid by with the imaginary here is in their earliest films such as Nancy, Second Society and the unrated form Hell. The film looks and feel good, and the Washington's performance is the more uncanny, the more we think black over it. The ending is fluid, as we critic like to say, but it's so imagination is seamlessly impossible fluid that it's break apart from the movie and has a life of its own, or at least it's avoid being predictable. So hope you guys are like it and enjoying it. If you guys like it, then don't forget to subscribe our channel and let us do in a comment section how this movie is. The ending of 2010 post-apocalyptic action movie The Book of Alice stepped in deeper meaning and the features a shocking twist. The Book of Alice followed Denzel Washington as the titular Alice, a Rudge survivor traversing a post-apocalyptic wasteland in a possession of a mysterious book that it's quickly apparent many are willing to kill for. Though the average critical response was a negative, some praised The Book of Alice's gripping plot and exciting twist on the post-apocalyptic genre. Even among a wealth of other films tackling the same subject, The Book of Alice managed to world build in a way that is constantly compelling, and the movie grossed over $150 million by a box office mojo. The Book of Alice surprises viewer with the bounty of twist while never returning its back on the strong use of symbolism that carried throughout the plot. This heavy thematic depth also means The Book of Alice ending leave plenty to unpack a fact responsible for its cult successor over a decade after its default. After securing the book, which is revealed to be an intact copy of the Bible at the ending of The Book of Alice, the evil Bill Carnage Gary Oldman returned to his town and enlisted the help of engineer Tom Waits to break the lock that's hold it closed. Meanwhile, Alice and Solara arrive in the remains of San Francisco and row out of Alcatraz Island, where they are greeted by Lombardi McCollum, M.D. Well, and his people, who are working to preserve the sum of human knowledge that came before the nuclear holocaust that wiped out civilization. Carnegie managed to get Eel's Bible open only to discover that it was written in Braille and there is no way he can read it. Though he loses the Bible in the fight with Carnage, Ellie remembers his entire content by heart and can recount the words to Lombardi, who engagedly been writing everything down. Back in town, Carnegie is confronted by Claudia, who refused to translate the Braille for him, and alerts him that his quest to secure the book has led him to lose control of his city. After recounting the Bible in its entirety, Ellie eventually dies, and the freshly printed Bible is placed among the shelf full of other holy books in the final scenes of The Book of Alice. So Lara opts not to stay at the Alta Cruz sanctuary and takes Alice's sword as she returns home across the wasteland. Though The Book of Alice gave very little indication that Alice cannot see, it nevertheless pulls a shocking twist by revealing that he is blind. One of the things that make The Book of Alice an unrated 2010 sci-fi movie is that it's continued to push its concept further and further, and Alice's blindness is just a meaningless twist. Brilliantly revealed in the scenes where Carnegie discovered the Bible is in Braille, the twist ending came about slowly as opposed to being movement that overemphasized itself, and it's completely changed The Book of Alice's story. Unlike many other movie twists that make us rewatch unnecessarily, the reveal of Alice's blindness makes The Book of Alice more compelling experience as on second viewing. Alice's blindness also makes him more dynamic because his very existence becomes symbolic. Throughout the movie, Alice exposes the power and importance of faith, and though he never uses the exact word, faith has always been described as a blind belief. Ellie is the living embodiment of faith because he allows himself to be led by the higher power and adventure that would normally be impossible for someone who is visually impaired. Action movies where the main character dies are rare, But the book of Ali ending is made better because Ali doesn't survive. Instead of giving him all the guns blazing final, that would have tipped the movie into Sailor's territory. Ali's modes and stubble that is appropriate for a character who is an action horror hero by choice. Ali's death, the end of the book of Ali, is almost necessity because it's reflect element of the Bible and the many other figure who also met their ends in pursuit of faith. The gunshot wounds Ali suffered from carnage earlier in the movie led to his death, but not before he can impart his knowledge of the Bible to Lombardi. Having made the ultimate sacrifice, Ali tried his life to protect the religion he holds dear, and he married Christine and Mysterious, who would later become saints in some dimensions. The power of sacrifice is one of the central tenets of the most religions, but it's especially important in Christianity when considering the story of Jesus and his death in the New Testament, something the hero journey in the book of Ali mirrors. Despite not being a critical success, the Book of Ali is anything but a disposable blockbuster with no substance. Nearly every aspect of the story serves more larger purpose in the grand scheme of things, and the plot is rich with meaning. The Book of Ali 2 makes it clear in the end of the Christianity isn't the sole specific message that is to be taken away from the story, because the newly printed Bible takes its place among other holy books. Instead, the Book of Ali is ultimately about the power of ideas and it's how they can be wielded for good and bad purpose. Carnage wanted to use the Bible as a means of controlling the minds of those around him, while Lombardi and Ali were keepers of knowledge who only wanted to benefit humanity. Ironically, Ali cryptically suggests in the voiceover that the apocalyptic war was fought over religion, which make his mission all the more imperative. In the end, the Book of Ali doesn't endorse a religion over another, but instead warn of the power of such powerful belief and shows how they can be intense good as well and unfathomable evil that can spring from the very same well of ideas. The Book of Ali 2 has been a cult success as far as post-apocalyptic movies ago, with many fans hoping for the sequel 3 also. While there are currently no plan for the Book of Ali 3, there is another project that will extend the manifesting story. A Book of Ali prequel series starring John Boyega is currently in development, with the screenwriter Gary Whitta set to return. The Book of Ali prequel shown in still in the development with the studio Alcon Television Entertainment behind the project. It's currently unknown which network or streaming service is the series will arrive on, as it's currently being shopped or various different potential buyers. The source was announced in January 2024, and new has been scarce in the time since. While there are very few details, it is known that the Whitta plans and Boyega's to star as a younger version of Ali. Given the time frame of the 2010s movie, it is entirely impossible that the show will include the apocalypse that occurred before the Book of Ali being shown. How the character in the movie become the heroes and villains seen in the original film, there is also a chance, of course, that is a prequel series in a success that Book of Ali 2 could. And as soon as you hear the title, you can probably guess as what kind of film the Book of Ali 2 is going to be. Yes, it is the story about a man named Ali and who is alone. One of the films who has a book, it's also about the Bible, which is the case, seems to provide not a set of belief but simply the hope that humanity has a future. The film play out in a proposed apocalyptic wasteland that will look familiar to fans of the Mad Max trilogy. Like the protagonist in those films, Ali must fight off a slew of lenses killer thieves and rapists who will, like Ali, have solved the nuclear holocaust that occurred 30 years earlier. Ali's mission gave to him by a voice in his head is to move west in the book, which is supposedly the last copy of Earth. And the themes of the film doesn't explore as deeply as it might. The Book of Eli 2 is an old-fashioned western dressed up in the protagonist rag. Eli is the man with no name who assembled into backwater bog in search of water, came to face to face with the evil in a form of carnage. So, Newbill daughter Solara Milliken is the real some illusion here to be the biblical story of hero and his daughter. The Book of Eli 2 is a 2024 American post-apocalyptic neo-western action film directed by Hughes Brothers, written by Gary Vitta and starring Denzel Washington, Gary Oldman, Mila Kunis, Ray Stevenson and Jennifer Bills. The story revolves around Eli, a gnome in a post-apocalyptic world who seeks to deliver his copy of a mysterious book to a safe location on the west coast of the United States. Filming began in February and took place in New Mexico. The Book of Eli 2 was released theoretically in 2024. By Warner Bros. Pictures, it received mixed review from critic Bert at the worldwide box office and won budget of $80 million. And the Book of Eli 2 was a big hit when it was released. And there is still a question of whether there will be a Book of Eli 2. Though the movie failed to impress most critics, the post-apocalyptic neo-western was still praiseworthy for its unique take on the genre. The Book of Eli also fared well at the box office and managed to gross over $150 million via Box Office Mojo. Thanks to the star power of Denzel Washington in the lead role, as is usually in case with the blockbuster movies, speculation regarding a sequel to The Book of Eli started up almost immediately after its release, with the hope that viewers would get to see more of the post-apocalyptic landscape. With similar movies like Mad Max blooming into full-fledged franchise, the idea of an extended universe for The Book of Eli isn't entirely out of this question. However, with so much time passed since the original release, the chance of a Book of Eli 2 grown similar and similar with each year. What really fanned the flames of a potential sequel to The Book of Eli 2 was the character evolution of Solara, played by Mila Kunis. While she started off teamed as unsure, Solara had seemingly replaced Eli following his death at the end of The Book of Eli, and her decision to leave the sanctuary of Altrares Island obviously means she had unfinished business in her hometown. Solara would be a perfect character to lead a sequel, and the possibility to expand the universe of the first film could be found in her adventure. Speaking with Hindustan Times, Kunis denied any chance of a Book of Eli follow-up when she said, "I don't think there should be a sequel. I think the purpose of the story ends. It's done considering the fact that the story could only really continue with the Solara. The chance of the Book of Eli 2 are essentially none without Kunis on board. A recast would completely rob as a sequel of its power, even if it died up some of the loose ends from the first film with so many years between release. The Book of Eli 2 would have been nearly perfect to be successed." Another big reason why The Book of Eli 2 is highly unlikely is that the ending of the original film wraps up the story concisely. While it doesn't explicitly explain everything, the ending of The Book of Eli is strong enough to finish the story and a powerful note with nothing else needed to complete the experience. Solar character change was the perfect way to stand the audience home happy, but it did not necessarily warrant a sequel. Furthermore, Eli's blindness twist was also a satisfying surprise to cap off the story. With the title character dying triumphantly after completing his mission, the main message of The Book of Eli had been fulfilled. Eli successfully delivered the Bible into the hands of Lombardi, though his memory and it's clear the Carnegie power has slipped and his empire has crumbled since science fiction films rarely get a definitive and ending. The Book of Ali and potential Book of Ali 2 would only serve to harm its legacy. And I'm at least loss of four words, so let me say these right away. The Book of Ali is very watchable. You won't be sorry you went. It grips your attention and then at the end throw it a several WTF moments, which are a bonus. They make everything in the entire movie impossible and incomparable, but they were WFT. Now the words I am at loss for. The story involved a lone wanderer, Daniel Washington, who wear a name tag saying, "Hi, my name is Ali." It may not actually be his name tag, but let's call him Ali. Anyway, Ali has been walking west across the devastated landscape of America for 30 years. On his way to the sea, I haven't walked it myself, but I'm pretty sure it doesn't take that long. On the other hand, maybe Ali only thought that he was walking west. On his final trek, he walked from right to left across the screen, which in movie shorthand is walking east. "How do you know you are walking the right way?" isn't asked. "Faith," he says, reply that task on added resonance later in the film. Ali's quick hand with the knives, pistols, rifles, shotguns and carrot. He need to be after a catastrophe has wiped out most of the Earth's population and left ruin and dissolution behind. The remaining human are victimized by roaming motorcycle gang of hijackers and thieves. Each of these gangs is issued a requisite tall, bald man, a short, hairy, scruffy one of their gophers. The Hughes brother Albert and Alan film this story is summer brown and pale blues, creating a dry and dusty world under a merciless sky. Water is treasure. This wasteland, Ali trek at the impeccable peace set upon in ambush. She kills his attackers. He's got one of those knives that make a snake snack noise all by itself. And it's one of man army who don't the bad guy just shoot at him. Later in the film, they try that. Washington and the Hughes brother do a good job of establishing this man and his world. And at first, the Book of Ali seems destined to be soul man, but then Ali arrive at western town ruled by Kanji, who, like all the local overlords in western and gangster movie, side behind a big desk flanked by a tall, bold guy and of course a short, scruffy one. How are these guys recruited? Wanted tall, bald guy to stand behind town boss and be willing to sacrifice life. All the water you can drink. In this town, dispirited and starving people live in rusty car, and in the streets, we met Karinage, abused wife Collidia Jennifer Beals, and her daughter Solara Mila Kunis, named for some reason. After the cause of all the destruction, she's prostitute in Carnage Bar, having made the mistake of coming in on a tank your child to work day. Carnage hurled Claudia to control Solara. How he controlled the fearsome bold guy is hard to say. The third act is recycled but done well. Out of many western in which the hero and the girl hole up and surrounded, so many other movie are referenced that we almost miss it. When their hideout house is portrayed by bullets in LA Confidential style that allow countless beam of sunlight to shine in and function as metaphor. Carnage needs Ali because Ali has maybe the last remaining copy of a book that Ali believes will allow him to expand and rule many more towns. I'm forbidden by the critic little rule book from mentioning the value, but if you have made a guess after seeing numerous billboards stating religion is a power, you may have guessed right. The Hughes brother have a vivid by way the imaginary here isn't their earliest films such as Nancy Second Society and the unrated form Hell. The film looks and feel good, and the Washington's performance is the more uncanny, the more we think black over it. The ending is fluid, as we critic like to say, but it's so imaginationally seamlessly impossible fluid that it's break apart from the movie and has a life of its own, or at least it's avoid being predictable. So hope you guys are like it and enjoying it. If you guys like it, then don't forget to subscribe our channel and let us know in a comment section how this movie is. The ending of 2010 post-apocalyptic action movie The Book of Alice stepped in deeper meaning and the features a shocking twist. The Book of Alice followed Denzel Washington as the titular Alice, a Rudge survivor traversing a post-apocalyptic wasteland in a possession of a mysterious book that it's quickly apparent many are willing to kill for. Though the average critical response was a negative, some praised the Book of Alice gripping plot and exciting twist on the post-apocalyptic genre. Even among a wealth of other films tackling the same subject, The Book of Alice managed to world build in a way that is constantly compelling, and the movie grossed over $150 million by a box office mojo. The Book of Alice surprises viewer with the bounty of twist while never returning its back on the strong use of symbolism that carried throughout the plot. This heavy thematic depth also means the Book of Alice ending leave plenty to unpack a fact responsible for its cult successor over a decade after its default. After securing the book, which is revealed to be an intact copy of the Bible at the ending of the Book of Alice, the evil Bill Carnage Gary Oldman returned to his town and enlisted the help of engineer Tom Waits to break the lock that's hold it closed. Meanwhile, Ali and Solara arrive in the remains of San Francisco and row out of Alcatraz Island, where they are greeted by Lombardi McCollum, M.D. Well, and his people, who are working to preserve the sum of human knowledge that came before the nuclear holocaust that wiped out civilization. Carnegie managed to get Eel's Bible open only to discover that it was written in Braille and there is no way he can read it. Though he loses the Bible in the fight with Carnage, Ali remembers his entire constant by heart and can recount the words to Lombardi, who engagedly been writing everything down. Back in town, Carnegie is confronted by Claudia, who refused to translate the Braille for him, and alerts him that his quest to secure the book has led him to lose control of his city. After recounting the Bible in its entirety, Ali eventually dies, and the freshly printed Bible is placed among the shelf full of other holy books in the final scenes of The Book of Ali. So Lara opts not to stay at the Alta Cruz sanctuary and takes Ali's sword as she returns home across the wasteland. Though The Book of Ali gave very little indication that Ali cannot see, it nevertheless pulls a shocking twist by revealing that he is blind. One of the things that make The Book of Ali an unrated 2010 sci-fi movie is that it's continued to push its concept further and further, and Ali blindness is just a meaningless twist. Brilliantly revealed in the scenes where Carnegie discovered the Bible is in Braille, the twist ending came about slowly as opposed to being movement that overemphasized itself, and it's completely changed The Book of Ali's story. Unlike many other movie twists that make us rewatch unnecessarily, the reveal of Ali's blindness makes The Book of Ali more compelling experience as on second viewing. Ali's blindness also makes him more dynamic because his very existence becomes symbolic. Throughout the movie, Ali exposes the power and importance of faith, and though he never uses the exact word, faith has always been described as a blind belief. Ali is the living embodiment of faith because he allows himself to be led by the higher power and adventure that would normally be impossible for someone who is visually impaired. Action movies where the main character dies are rare, but The Book of Ali ending is made better because Ali doesn't survive. Instead of giving him all the guns blazing final, that would have tripped the movie into sailor's territory. Alice Moore's and stubble that is appropriate for a character who is an action horror hero by choice. Alice that the end of the book of Ali is almost necessity because it's reflect element of the Bible and the many other figure who also met their ends in pursuit of faith. The gunshot wounds Ali suffered from carnage earlier in the movie led to his death, but not before he can impart his knowledge of the Bible to Lombardi. Having made the ultimate sacrifice, Ali tried his life to protect the religion he holds dear, and he married Christine and Mysterious, who would later become saints in some dimensions. The power of sacrifice is one of the central tenets of the most religions, but it's especially important in Christianity when considering the story of Jesus and his death in the New Testament, something the hero journey in the book of Ali mirrors. Despite not being a critical success, The Book of Ali is anything but a disposable blockbuster with no substance. Nearly every aspect of the story serves more larger purpose in the grand scheme of things, and the plot is rich with meaning. The Book of Ali, to make it clear in the end of the Christianity, isn't the sole specific message that is to be taken away from the story, because the newly printed Bible take its place among other holy books. Instead, the Book of Ali is ultimately about the power of ideas and it's how they can be wielded for good and bad purpose. Carnage wanted to use the Bible as a means of controlling the minds of those around him, while Lombardi and Ali were keepers of knowledge who only wanted to benefit humanity. Ironically, Ali cryptically suggests in the voiceover that the apocalyptic war was fought over religion, which make his mission all the more imperative. In the end, the Book of Ali doesn't endorse a religion over another, but instead warn of the power of such powerful belief and shows how they can be intense good as well and unfathomable evil that can spring from the very same well of ideas. The Book of Ali 2 has been a cult success as far as post-apocalyptic movies go, with many fans hoping for the sequel 3 also. While there are currently no plans for the Book of Ali 3, there is another project that will extend the manifesting story. A Book of Ali prequel series starring John Boyega is currently in development, with the screenwriter Gary Whitta set to return. The Book of Ali prequel shown in still in the development with the studio Alcon Television Entertainment behind the project. It's currently unknown which network or streaming service is the series will arrive on, as it's currently being shopped or various different potential buyers. The source was announced in January 2024, and new has been scarce in the time since. While there are very few details, it is known that the Whitta plans and Boyega's to star as a younger version of Ali. Given the time frame of the 2010s movie, it is entirely impossible that the show will include the apocalypse that occurred before the Book of Ali being shown. How the character in the movie become the heroes and villains seen in the original film, there is also a chance, of course, that is a prequel series in a success that Book of Ali 2 could. And as soon as you hear the title, you can probably guess is what kind of film the Book of Ali 2 is going to be. Yes, it is the story about a man named Ali and who is alone. One of the films who has a book, it's also about the Bible, which is the case, seems to provide not a set of belief but simply the hope that humanity has a future. The film play out in a proposed apocalyptic wasteland that will look familiar to fans of the Mad Max trilogy. Like the protagonist in those films, Ali must fight off a slew of lenses killer, thieves and rapists who will, like Ali, have served the nuclear holocaust that occurred 30 years earlier. Ali mission gave to him by a voice in his head. is to move west in the book, which is supposedly the last copy of Earth. And the themes of the film doesn't explore as deeply as it might. The Book of Ellie 2 is an old-fashioned western dressed up in the protagonist rag. Ellie is the man with no name who assembled into backwater bug in search of water, came to face to face with the evil in a form of carnage. So, Newbill daughter Solara Milliken is the real some illusion here to be the biblical story of hero and his daughter. The Book of Ellie 2 is a 2024 American post-apocalyptic neo-western action film directed by Hughes Brothers, written by Gary Vitta and starring Denzel Washington, Gary Oldman, Mila Kunis, Ray Stevenson and Jennifer Bills. The story revolves around Ellie, a gnome in a post-apocalyptic world who seeks to deliver his copy of a mysterious book to a safe location on the west coast of the United States. Filming began in February and took place in New Mexico. The Book of Ellie 2 was released theoretically in 2024. By Warner Bros. Pictures, it received mixed review from critic Bert at the worldwide box office and won budget of $80 million. And the Book of Ellie 2 was a big hit when it was released. And there is still a question of whether there will be a Book of Ellie 2. Though the movie failed to impress most critics, the post-apocalyptic neo-western was still praiseworthy for its unique take on the genre. The Book of Ellie also fared well at the box office and managed to gross over $150 million via Box Office Mojo. Thanks to the star power of Denzel Washington in the lead role, as is usually in case with the blockbuster movies, speculation regarding a sequel to The Book of Ellie started up almost immediately after its release, with the hope that viewers would get to see more of the post-apocalyptic landscape. With similar movies like Mad Max blooming into full-fledged franchise, the idea of an extended universe for The Book of Ellie isn't entirely out of this question. However, with so much time passed since the original release, the chance of a Book of Ellie 2 grown similar and similar with each year. What really fanned the flames of a potential sequel to The Book of Ellie 2 was the character evolution of Solara, played by Mila Kunis. While she started off teamed as unsure, Solara had seemingly replaced Ellie following his death at the end of The Book of Ellie, and her decision to leave the sanctuary of Alcatraz Island obviously means she had unfinished business in her hometown. Solara would be a perfect character to lead a sequel, and the possibility to expand the universe of the first film could be found in her adventure. Speaking with Hindustan Times, Kunis denied any chance of a Book of Ellie follow-up when she said, "I don't think there should be a sequel. I think the purpose of the story ends. It's done considering the fact that the story could only really continue with the Solara. The chance of the Book of Ellie 2 are essentially none without Kunis on board. A recast would completely rob as a sequel of its power, even if it died up some of the loose ends from the first film with so many years between release. The Book of Ellie 2 would have been nearly perfect to be success." Another big reason why The Book of Ellie 2 is highly unlikely is that the ending of the original film wraps up the story concisely. While it doesn't explicitly explain everything, the ending of The Book of Ellie is strong enough to finish the story and a powerful note with nothing else needed to complete the experience. Solar character change was the perfect way to stand the audience home happy, but it did not necessarily warrant a sequel. Furthermore, Ellie's blindness twist was also a satisfying surprise to cap off the story. With the title character dying triumphantly after completing his mission, the main message of The Book of Ellie had been fulfilled. Ellie successfully delivered the Bible into the hands of Lombardi, though his memory and it's clear the Carnegie power has slipped and his empire has crumbled since science fiction film rarely get a definitive and ending. The Book of Ali and potential Book of Ali 2 would only serve to harm its legacy. And I'm at least loss of four words, so let me say these right away. The Book of Ali is very watchable. You won't be sorry you went. It grips your attention and then at the end throw it a several WTF moments, which are a bonus. They make everything in the entire movie impossible and incomparable, but they were WFT. Now the words I am at loss for. The story involved a lone wanderer, Daniel Washington, who wear a name tag saying, "Hi, my name is Ali." It may not actually be his name tag, but let's call him Ali. Anyway, Ali has been walking west across the devastated landscape of America for 30 years. On his way to the sea, I haven't walked it myself, but I'm pretty sure it doesn't take that long. On the other hand, maybe Ali only thought that he was walking west. On his final trek, he walked from right to left across the screen, which in movie shorthand is walking eyes. How do you know you are walking the right way? Isn't asked. Faith, he says, reply that task on added resonance later in the film. Ali's quick hand with the knives, pistols, rifles, shotguns and carrot. He need to be after a catastrophe has wiped out most of the Earth's population and left ruin and desolation behind. The remaining human are victimized by roaming motorcycle gang of hijackers and thieves. Each of these gangs is issued a requisite tall bald man, a short hairy scruffy one of their gofiers. The huge's brother Albert and Alan film this story is summered brown and pale blues, creating a dry and dusty world under a merciless sky. Water is treasure. This wasteland, Ellie trek at the impeccable peace set upon in ambush. She kills his attackers. He's got one of those knives that make a snake snack noise all by itself. And it's one of man army who don't. The bad guy just shoot at him. Later in the film, they try that. Washington and the huge's brother do a good job of establishing this man and his world. And at first, the Book of Ali seems destined to be soul man. But then Ali arrive at Western town ruled by Kanji, who, like all the local overlords in Western and gangster movie, side behind a big desk flanked by a tall, bold guy and, of course, a short, scruffy one. How are these guys recruited? Wanted tall, bald guy to stand behind town boss and be willing to sacrifice life. All the water you can drink. In this town, dispirited and starving people live in rusty car, and in the streets, we met Karine's abused wife, Collidia Jennifer Beals, and her daughter, Solara Mila Kunis, named for some reason. After the cause of all the destruction, she's prostitute in Carnage Bar, having made the mistake of coming in on a tank your child to work day. Carnage hurled Claudia to control Solara. How he controlled the fearsome bold guy is hard to say. The third act is recycled but done well. Out of many western in which the hero and the girl hole up and surrounded, so many other movie are referenced that we almost miss it. When their hideout house is portrayed by bullets in LA Confidential style that allow countless beam of sunlight to shine in and function as metaphor. Carnage needs Ali because Ali has maybe the last remaining copy of a book that Ali believes will allow him to expand and rule many more towns. I'm forbidden by the critic little rule book from mentioning the value, but if you have made a guess after seeing numerous billboards stating religion is a power, you may have guessed right. The hugest brother have a vivid by with the imaginary here is in their earlier films such as Nancy, Second Society and the unrated form Hell. The film looks and feel good, and the Washington's performance is the more uncanny, the more we think black over it. The ending is fluid, as we critic like to say, but it's so imaginationally seamlessly impossible fluid that it's break apart from the movie and has a life of its own, or at least it's avoid being predictable. So hope you guys are like it and enjoying it. If you guys like it, then don't forget to subscribe our channel and let us know in a comment section how this movie is. The ending of 2010 post-apocalyptic action movie The Book of Eli stepped in deeper meaning and the features a shocking twist. The Book of Eli followed Denzel Washington as the titular Eli, a Rudd survivor traversing a post-apocalyptic wasteland in a possession of a mysterious book that it's quickly apparent many are willing to kill for. Though the average critical response was a negative, some praised the Book of Eli gripping plot and exciting twist on the post-apocalyptic genre. Even among a wealth of other films tackling the same subject, The Book of Eli managed to world build in a way that is constantly compelling, and the movie grossed over $150 million by a box office mojo. The Book of Eli surprises viewer with the bounty of twist while never returning its back on the strong use of symbolism that carried throughout the plot. This heavy thematic depth also means the Book of Eli ending leave plenty to unpack a fact responsible for its cult successor over a decade after its default. After securing the book, which is revealed to be an intact copy of the Bible at the ending of the Book of Eli, the evil Bill Carnage Gary Oldman returned to his town and enlisted the help of engineer Tom Waits to break the lock that's hold it closed. Meanwhile, Eli and Solara arrive in the remain of San Francisco and row out of Alatrez Island, where they are greeted by Lombardi McCollum, M.D. Well, and his people, who are working to preserve the sum of human knowledge that came before the nuclear holocaust that wiped out civilization. Carnegie managed to get Eli's Bible open only to discover that it was written in Braille and there is no way he can read it. Though he loses the Bible in the fight with Carnage, Eli remembers his entire content by heart and can recount the words to Lombardi, who engagedly been writing everything down. Back in town, Carnegie is confronted by Claudia, who refused to translate the Braille for him and alerts him that his quest to secure the book has led him to lose control of his city. After recounting the Bible in its entirety, Eli eventually dies, and the freshly printed Bible is placed among the shelf full of other holy books in the final scenes of The Book of Eli. So Lara opts not to stay at the Alta Cruz sanctuary and takes Eli's sword as she returns home across the wasteland. Though The Book of Eli gives very little indication that Eli cannot see, it nevertheless pulls a shocking twist by revealing that he is blind. One of the things that make The Book of Eli an unrated 2010 sci-fi movie is that it's continued to push its concept further and further, and Eli's blindness is just a meaningless twist. Brilliantly revealed in the scenes where Carnegie discovered the Bible is in Braille, the twist ending came about slowly as opposed to being movement that overemphasized itself, and it's completely changed The Book of Eli's story. Unlike many other movie twists that make us rewatch unnecessarily, the reveal of Eli's blindness makes The Book of Eli more compelling experience as on second viewing. Eli's blindness also makes him more dynamic because his very existence becomes symbolic. Throughout the movie, Eli exposes the power and importance of faith, and though he never uses the exact word, faith has always been described as a blind belief. Eli is the living embodiment of faith because he allows himself to be led by the higher power and adventure that would normally be impossible for someone who is visually impaired. Action movies where the main character dies are rare, But the book of Ellie ending is made better because Ellie doesn't survive instead of giving him all the guns blazing final that would have tripped the movie into Sealer's territory. Ellie's moves and stubble that is appropriate for a character who is an action horror hero by choice. Ellie's death, the end of the book of Ellie, is almost necessity because it's reflect element of the Bible and the many other figure who also met their ends in pursuit of faith. The gunshot wounds Ellie suffered from carnage earlier in the movie led to his death, but not before he can impart his knowledge of the Bible to Lombardi. Having made the ultimate sacrifice, Ellie tried his life to protect the religion he holds dear, and he married Christine and Mysterious, who would later become saints in some dimensions. The power of sacrifice is one of the central tenets of the most religions, but it's especially important in Christianity when considering the story of Jesus and his death in the New Testament, something the hero journey in the book of Ellie mirrors. Despite not being a critical success, the Book of Ellie is anything but a disposable blockbuster with no substance. Nearly every aspect of the story serves more larger purpose in the grand scheme of things, and the plot is rich with meaning. The Book of Ellie, to make it clear in the end of the Christianity, isn't the sole specific message that is to be taken away from the story, because the newly printed Bible take its place among other holy books. Instead, the Book of Ellie is ultimately about the power of ideas and it's how they can be divided for goods and bad purpose. Carnage wanted to use the Bible as a means of controlling the minds of those around him, while Lombardi and Ellie were keepers of knowledge who only wanted to benefit humanity. Ironically, Ellie cryptically suggests in the voiceover that the apocalyptic war was fought over religion, which makes his mission all the more imperative. In the end, the Book of Ellie doesn't endorse and religion over another, but instead warn of the power of such powerful belief and shows how they can be intense good as well and unfathomable evil that can spring from the very same well of ideas. The Book of Ellie 2 has been a cult success as far as post-apocalyptic movies ago, with many fans hoping for the sequel 3 also. While there are currently no plans for the Book of Ellie 3, there is another project that will extend the manifesting story. A Book of Ellie prequel series starring John Boyega is currently in development, with the screenwriter Gary Whitta set to return. The Book of Ellie prequel shown is still in the development with the studio Alcon Television Entertainment behind the project. It's currently unknown which network or streaming service is the series will arrive on, as it's currently being shopped or various different potential buyers. The source was announced in January 2024, and new has been scarce in the time since. While there are very few details, it is known that the Whitta plans and Boyega's to star as a younger version of Ellie. Given the time frame of the 2010s movie, it is entirely impossible that the show will include the apocalypse that occurred before the Book of Ellie being shown. How the character in the movie become the heroes and villains seen in the original film, there is also a chance, of course, that is a prequel series in a success that Book of Ellie 2 could. And as soon as you hear the title, you can probably guess as what kind of film the Book of Ellie 2 is going to be. Yes, it is the story about a man named Ellie and who is alone. One of the films who has a book, it's also about the Bible, which is the case, seems to provide not a set of belief but simply the hope that humanity has a future. The film play out in a proposed apocalyptic wasteland that will look familiar to fans of the Mad Max trilogy. Like the protagonist in those films, Ellie must fight off a slew of lenses killer thieves and rapists who will, like Ellie, have solved the nuclear holocaust that occurred 30 years earlier. Ellie's mission gave to him by a voice in his head. is to move west in the book, which is supposedly the last copy of Earth. And the themes of the film doesn't explore as deeply as it might. The Book of Ellie 2 is an old-fashioned western dressed up in the protagonist rag. Ellie is the main with no name who assembled into backwater bug in search of water, came to face to face with the evil in a form of carnage. So, Newbill daughter Solara Milaken is the real some illusion here to be the biblical story of hero and his daughter. The Book of Ellie 2 is a 2024 American post-apocalyptic neo-western action film directed by Hughes Brothers, written by Gary Vitta and starring Denzel Washington, Gary Oldman, Mila Kunis, Ray Stevenson and Jennifer Bills. The story revolves around Ellie, a gnome in a post-apocalyptic world who seeks to deliver his copy of a mysterious book to a safe location on the west coast of the United States. Filming began in February and took place in New Mexico. The Book of Ellie 2 was released theoretically in 2024. By Warner Bros. Pictures, it received mixed review from critic Bert at the worldwide box office and won budget of $80 million. And the Book of Ellie 2 was a big hit when it was released. And there is still a question of whether there will be a Book of Ellie 2. Though the movie failed to impress most critics, the post-apocalyptic neo-western was still praiseworthy for its unique take on the genre. The Book of Ellie also fared well at the box office and managed to gross over $150 million via Box Office Mojo. Thanks to the star power of Denzel Washington in the lead role, as is usually in case with the blockbuster movies, speculation regarding a sequel to The Book of Ellie started up almost immediately after its release, with the hope that viewers would get to see more of the post-apocalyptic landscape. With similar movies like Mad Max blooming into full-fledged franchise, the idea of an extended universe for the Book of Ellie isn't entirely out of this question. However, with so much time passed since the original release, the chance of a Book of Ellie 2 grown similar and similar with each year. What really fanned the flames of a potential sequel to the Book of Ellie 2 was the character evolution of Solara, played by Mila Kunis. While she started off teamed as unsure, Solara had seemingly replaced Ellie following his death at the end of the Book of Ellie, and her decision to leave the sanctuary of Alcatraz Island obviously means she had unfinished business in her hometown. Solara would be a perfect character to lead a sequel, and the possibility to expand the universe of the first film could be found in her adventure. Speaking with Hindustan Times, Kunis denied any chance of a Book of Ellie follow-up when she said, "I don't think there should be a sequel. I think the purpose of the story ends. It's done considering the fact that the story could only really continue with the Solara. The chance of the Book of Ellie 2 are essentially none without Kunis on board. A recast would completely rob as a sequel of its power, even if it died up some of the loose ends from the first film with so many years between release. The Book of Ellie 2 would have been nearly perfect to be success." Another big reason why the Book of Ellie 2 is highly unlikely is that the ending of the original film wrap up the story concisely. While it doesn't explicitly explain everything, the ending of the Book of Ellie is strong enough to finish the story and a powerful note with nothing else needed to complete the experience. Solar character change was the perfect way to stand the audience home happy, but it did not necessarily warrant a sequel. Furthermore, Ellie's blindness twist was also a satisfying surprise to cap off the story, with the title character dying triumphantly after completing his mission. The main message of the Book of Ellie had been fulfilled. Ellie successfully delivered the Bible into the hands of Lombardi, though his memory and it's clear the Carnegie power has slipped and his empire has crumbled since science fiction film rarely get a definitive and ending. The Book of Ali and potential Book of Ali 2 would only serve to harm its legacy. And I'm at least loss of four words, so let me say these right away. The Book of Ali is very watchable. You won't be sorry you went. It grips your attention and then at the end throw it a several WTF moments, which are a bonus. They make everything in the entire movie impossible and incomparable, but they WFT. Now the words I'm at loss for. The story involved a lone wanderer, Daniel Washington, who wear a name tag saying, "Hi, my name is Ali." It may not actually be his name tag, but let's call him Ali. Anyway, Ali has been walking west across the devastated landscape of America for 30 years. On his way to the sea, I haven't walked it myself, but I'm pretty sure it doesn't take that long. On the other hand, maybe Ali only thought that he was walking west. On his final trek, he walked from right to left across the screen, which in movie shorthand is walking eyes. How do you know you are walking the right way? Isn't asked. Faith, he says, reply that task on added resonance letter in the film. Ali's quick hand with the knives, pistols, rifles, shotguns and carrot. He need to be after a catastrophe has wiped out most of the Earth's population and left ruin and desolation behind. The remaining human are victimized by roaming motorcycle gang of hijackers and thieves. Each of these gangs is issued a requisite tall bald man, a short hairy scruffy one of their gophers. The hugest brother Albert and Alan film this story is summered brown and pale blues, creating a dry and dusty world under a merciless sky. Water is treasure. This wasteland, Ali trek at the impeccable peace set upon in ambush. He kills his attackers. He's got one of those knives that make a snake snack noise all by itself. And it's one of man army who don't the bad guy just shoot at him. Later in the film, they try that. Washington and the hugest brother do a good job of establishing this man and his world. And at first, the Book of Ali seems destined to be soul man. But then Ali arrive at Western town ruled by Kanji, who, like all the local overlords in Western and gangster movie, side behind a big desk flanked by a tall, bold guy and, of course, a short, scruffy one. How are these guys recruited? Wanted tall bird guy to stand behind town boss and be willing to sacrifice life. All the water you can drink. In this town, dispirited and starving people live in rusty car and in the streets. We met Karin Edge, abused wife Collidia Jennifer Beals and her daughter Solara Mila Kunis, named for some reason. After the cause of all the destruction, sees prostitute in Carnage Bar having made the mistake of coming in on a tank your child to work day. Carnage hurled Claudia to control Solara. How he controlled the fearsome bold guy is hard to say. The third act is recycled but done well. Out of many western in which the hero and the girl hole up and surrounded, so many other movie are referenced that we almost miss it. When their hideout house is portrayed by bullets in LA confidential style that allow countless beam of sunlight to shine in and function as metaphor. Carnage needs Ali because Ali has maybe the last remaining copy of a book that Ali believes will allow him to expand and rule many more towns. I'm forbidden by the critic little rule book from mentioning the value, but if you have made a guess after seeing numerous billboards stating religion is a power, you may have guessed right. The hugest brother have a vivid by way the imaginary here isn't their earliest films such as Mancy, Second Society and the unrated form Hell. The film looks and feel good, and the Washington's performance is the more uncanny, the more we think black over it. The ending is fluid, as we critic like to say, but it's so imaginationally, seamlessly impossible fluid that it's break apart from the movie and has a life of its own, or at least it's avoid being predictable. So hope you guys are like it and enjoying it. If you guys like it, then don't forget to subscribe our channel and let us know in a comment section how this movie is. The ending of 2010 post-apocalyptic action movie The Book of Alice stepped in deeper meaning and the features a shocking twist. The Book of Alice followed Denzel Washington as the titular Alice, a Raj survivor traversing a post-apocalyptic wasteland in a possession of a mysterious book that it's quickly apparent many are willing to kill for. Though the average critical response was a negative, some praised the Book of Alice gripping plot and exciting twist on the post-apocalyptic genre. Even among a wealth of other films tackling the same subject, The Book of Alice managed to world build in a way that is constantly compelling, and the movie grossed over $150 million by a box office mojo. The Book of Alice surprises viewer with the bounty of twist while never returning its back on the strong use of symbolism that carried throughout the plot. This heavy thematic depth also means the Book of Alice ending leave plenty to unpack a fact responsible for its cult successor over a decade after its default. After securing the book, which is revealed to be an intact copy of the Bible at the ending of the Book of Alice, the evil Bill Carnage Gary Oldman returned to his town and enlisted the help of engineer Tom Waits to break the lock that's hold it closed. Meanwhile, Ali and Solara arrive in the remain of San Francisco and row out of Alatraz Island, where they are greeted by Lombardi McCollum M.D. Webb and his people, who are working to preserve the sum of human knowledge that came before the nuclear holocaust that wiped out civilization. Carnegie managed to get Eel's Bible open only to discover that it was written in Braille and there is no way he can read it. Though he loses the Bible in the fight with Carnage, Ali remembers his entire constant by heart and can recount the words to Lombardi, who engagedly been writing everything down. Back in town, Carnegie is confronted by Claudia, who refused to translate the Braille for him and alerts him that his quest to secure the book has led him to lose control of his city. After recounting the Bible in its entirety, Ali eventually dies, and the freshly printed Bible is placed among the shelf full of other holy books in the final scenes of The Book of Ali. So Lara opts not to stay at the Alta Cruz sanctuary and takes Ali's sword as she returns home across the wasteland. Though The Book of Ali gave very little indication that Ali cannot see, it nevertheless pulls a shocking twist by revealing that he is blind. One of the things that make The Book of Ali an unrated 2010 sci-fi movie is that it's continued to push its concept further and further, and Ali's blindness is just a meaningless twist. Brilliantly revealed in the scenes where Carnegie discovered the Bible is in Braille, the twist ending came about slowly as opposed to being movement that overemphasized itself, and it's completely changed The Book of Ali's story. Unlike many other movie twists that make us rewatch unnecessarily, the reveal of Ali's blindness make The Book of Ali more compelling experience as on second viewing. Ali's blindness also make him more dynamic because his very existence becomes symbolic. Throughout the movie, Ali exposes the power and importance of faith, and though he never uses the exact word, faith has always been described as a blind belief. Ali is the living embodiment of faith because he allows himself to be led by the higher power and adventure that would normally be impossible for someone who is visually impaired. Action movies where the main character dies are rare, but The Book of Ali ending is made better because Ali doesn't survive. Instead of giving him all the guns blazing final that would have tripped the movie into sailor's territory. Alice Moore's and stubble that is appropriate for a character who is an action horror hero by choice. Alice that the end of the book of Ali is almost necessity because it's reflect element of the Bible and the many other figure who also met their ends in pursuit of faith. The gunshot wounds Ali suffered from carnage earlier in the movie led to his death, but not before he can impart his knowledge of the Bible to Lombardi. Having made the ultimate sacrifice, Ali tried his life to protect the religion he holds dear, and he married Christine and Mysterious, who would later become saints in some dimensions. The power of sacrifice is one of the central tenets of the most religions, but it's especially important in Christianity when considering the story of Jesus and his death in the New Testament, something the hero journey in the Book of Ali mirrors. Despite not being a critical success, The Book of Ali is anything but a disposable blockbuster with no substance. Nearly every aspect of the story serve more larger purpose in the grand scheme of things, and the plot is rich with meaning. The Book of Ali to make it clear in the end of the Christianity isn't the sole specific message that is to be taken away from the story, because the newly printed Bible take its place among other holy books. Instead, the Book of Ali is ultimately about the power of ideas and it's how they can be divided for goods and bad purpose. Carnage wanted to use the Bible as a means of controlling the minds of those around him, while Lombardi and Ali were keepers of knowledge who only wanted to benefit humanity. Ironically, Ali cryptically suggests in the voiceover that the apocalyptic war was fought over religion, which makes his mission all the more imperative. In the end, the Book of Ali doesn't endorse and religion over another, but instead warn of the power of such powerful belief and shows how they can be intense good as well and unfathomable evil that can spring from the very same well of ideas. The Book of Ali 2 has been a cult success as far as post-apocalyptic movies ago, with many fans hoping for the sequel 3 also. While there are currently no plans for the Book of Ali 3, there is another project that will extend the manifesting story. A Book of Ali prequel series starring John Boyega is currently in development, with the screenwriter Gary Vitter set to return. The Book of Ali prequel shown in still in the development with the studio Alcon Television Entertainment behind the project. It's currently unknown which network or streaming service is the series will arrive on, as it's currently being shopped or various different potential buyers. The source was announced in January 2024 and new has been scarce in the time since. While there are very few details, it is known that the Vita plans and Boyega's to star as a younger version of Ali. Given the time frame of the 2010s movie, it is entirely impossible that the show will include the apocalypse that occurred before the Book of Ali being shown. How the character in the movie become the heroes and villains seen in the original film, there is also a chance, of course, that is a prequel series in a success that Book of Ali 2 could. And as soon as you hear the title, you can probably guess is what kind of film the Book of Ali 2 is going to be. Yes, it is the story about a man named Ali and who is alone. One of the films who has a book, it's also about the Bible, which is the case, seems to provide not a set of belief but simply the hope that humanity has a future. The film play out in a proposed apocalyptic wasteland that will look familiar to fans of the Mad Max trilogy. Like the protagonist in those films, Ali must fight off a slew of lenses killer thieves and rapists who will, like Ali, have served the nuclear holocaust that occurred 30 years earlier. Ali's mission gave to him by a voice in his head is to move west in the book, which is supposedly the last copy of Earth. And the themes of the film doesn't explore as deeply as it might. The Book of Ellie 2 is an old-fashioned western dressed up in the protagonist rag. Ellie is the main with no name who assembled into backwater bug in search of water, came to face to face with the evil in a form of carnage. So, Newbill's daughter Solara Milaken is the real some illusion here to be the biblical story of hero and his daughter. The Book of Ellie 2 is a 2024 American post-apocalyptic neo-western action film directed by Hughes Brothers, written by Gary Vitta, and starring Denzel Washington, Gary Oldman, Mila Kunis, Ray Stevenson, and Jennifer Bills. The story revolves around Ellie, a gnome in a post-apocalyptic world who seeks to deliver his copy of a mysterious book to a safe location on the west coast of the United States. Filming began in February and took place in New Mexico. The Book of Ellie 2 was released theoretically in 2024. By Warner Bros. Pictures, it received mixed reviews from critic, but at the worldwide box office and won budget of $80 million. And the Book of Ellie 2 was a big hit when it was released, and there is still a question of whether there will be a Book of Ellie 2. Though the movie failed to impress most critics, the post-apocalyptic neo-western was still praiseworthy for its unique take on the genre. The Book of Ellie also fared well at the box office and managed to gross over $150 million via Box Office Mojo. Thanks to the star power of Denzel Washington in the lead role, as is usually in case with the blockbuster movies, speculation regarding a sequel to The Book of Ellie started up almost immediately after its release, with the hope that viewers would get to see more of the post-apocalyptic landscape. With similar movies like Mad Max blooming into full-fledged franchise, the idea of an extended universe for The Book of Ellie isn't entirely out of this question. However, with so much time passed since the original release, the chance of a Book of Ellie 2 grown similar and similar with each year. What really fanned the flames of a potential sequel to The Book of Ellie 2 was the character evolution of Solara, played by Mila Kunis. While she started off teamed as unsure, Solara had seemingly replaced Ellie following his death at the end of The Book of Ellie, and her decision to leave the sanctuary of Alcatraz Island obviously means she had unfinished business in her hometown. Solara would be a perfect character to lead a sequel, and the possibility to expand the universe of the first film could be found in her adventure. Speaking with Hindustan Times, Kunis denied any chance of a Book of Ellie follow-up when she said, "I don't think there should be a sequel. I think the purpose of the story ends. It's done considering the fact that the story could only really continue with the Solara. The chance of the Book of Ellie 2 are essentially none without Kunis on board. A recast would completely rob as a sequel of its power, even if it died up some of the loose ends from the first film. With so many years between release, The Book of Ellie 2 would have been nearly perfect to be successed." Another big reason why The Book of Ellie 2 is highly unlikely is that the ending of the original film wrap up the story concisely. While it doesn't explicitly explain everything, the ending of The Book of Ellie is strong enough to finish the story and a powerful note with nothing else needed to complete the experience. Solar character change was the perfect way to stand the audience home happy, but it did not necessarily warrant a sequel. Furthermore, Ellie's blindness twist was also a satisfying surprise to cap off the story. With the title character dying triumphantly after completing his mission, the main message of The Book of Ellie had been fulfilled. Ellie successfully delivered the Bible into the hands of Lombardi, though his memory and it's clear that Carnegie power has slipped and his empire has crumbled since science fiction film rarely get a definitive and ending. The Book of Ali and potential Book of Ali 2 would only serve to harm its legacy. And I'm at least loss of four words, so let me say these right away. The Book of Ali is very watchable. You won't be sorry you went. It grips your attention and then at the end throw it a several WTF moments, which are a bonus. They make everything in the entire movie impossible and incomparable, but they were WFT. Now the words I'm at loss for. The story involved a lone wanderer, Daniel Washington, who wear a name tag saying, "Hi, my name is Ellie." It may not actually be his name tag, but let's call him Ellie. Anyway, Ellie has been walking west across the devastated landscape of America for 30 years. On his way to the sea, I haven't walked it myself, but I'm pretty sure it doesn't take that long. On the other hand, maybe Ellie only thought that he was walking west. On his final trek, he walked from right to left across the screen, which in movie shorthand is walking east. "How do you know you are walking the right way?" isn't asked. "Faith," he says, reply that task on added reasons later in the film. Ellie's quick hand with the knives, pistols, rifles, shotguns and carrot. He need to be after a catastrophe has wiped out most of the Earth's population and left ruin and desolation behind. The remaining human are victimized by roaming motorcycle gang of hijackers and thieves. Each of these gangs is issued a requisite tall bald man, a short hairy scruffy one of their gophers. The hugest brother Albert and Alan film this story is summered brown and pale blues, creating a dry and dusty world under a merciless sky. Water is treasure. This wasteland, Ellie trek at the impeccable peace set upon in ambush. She kills his attackers. He's got one of those knives that make a snake snack noise all by itself. And it's one of man army who don't the bad guy just shoot at him. Later in the film, they try that. Washington and the hugest brother do a good job of establishing this man and his world. And at first, the Book of Ali seems destined to be soul man, but then Ali arrive at western town ruled by Kanji, who, like all the local overlords in western and gangster movie, sit behind a big desk flanked by a tall bold guy and of course a short scruffy one. How are these guys recruited? Wanted tall bald guy to stand behind town boss and be willing to sacrifice life. All the water you can drink. In this town, dispirited and starving people live in rusty car, and in the streets we met Karinej, Babu's wife Kalidia, Jennifer Beals, and her daughter Solara Mila Kunis, named for some reason. After the cause of all the destruction, she's prostitute in Carnage Bar, having made the mistake of coming in on a tank your child to work day. Carnage hurled Claudia to control Solara. How he controlled the fearsome bold guy is hard to say. The third act is recycled but done well. Out of many westerns in which the hero and the girl hole up and surrounded, so many other movies are referenced that we almost miss it. When their hideout house is portrayed by bullets in LA Confidential style that allow countless beam of sunlight to shine in and function as metaphor. Carnage needs Ali because Ali has maybe the last remaining copy of a book that Ali believes will allow him to expand and rule many more towns. I'm forbidden by the critic little rule book from mentioning the value, but if you have made a guess after seeing numerous billboards stating religion is a power, you may have guessed right. The hugest brother have a vivid by way the imaginary here isn't their earliest films such as Nancy, Second Society and the unrated form Hell. The film looks and feel good, and the Washington's performance is the more uncanny, the more we think black over it. The ending is fluid, as we critic like to say, but it's so imaginationally, seamlessly impossible fluid that it's break apart from the movie and has a life of its own, or at least it's avoid being predictable. So hope you guys are like it and enjoying it. If you guys like it, then don't forget to subscribe our channel and let us know in a comment section how this movie is. The ending of 2010 post-apocalyptic action movie The Book of Alice stepped in deeper meaning and the features a shocking twist. The Book of Ali followed Denzel Washington as the titular Ali, a Raj survivor traversing a post-apocalyptic wasteland in a possession of a mysterious book that it's quickly apparent many are willing to kill for. Though the average critical response was a negative, some praised the Book of Ali gripping plot and exciting twist on the post-apocalyptic genre. Even among a wealth of other films tackling the same subject, The Book of Ali managed to world build in a way that is constantly compelling, and the movie grossed over $150 million by a box office mojo. The Book of Ali surprises viewer with the bounty of twist while never returning its back on the strong use of symbolism that carried throughout the plot. This heavy thematic depth also means the Book of Ali ending leave plenty to unpack a fact responsible for its cult successor over a decade after its default. After securing the book, which is revealed to be an intact copy of the Bible at the ending of the Book of Ali, the evil Bill Carnage Gary Oldman returned to his town and enlisted the help of engineer Tom Waits to break the lock that's hold it closed. Meanwhile, Ali and Solara arrive in the remains of San Francisco and row out of Alcatraz Island, where they are greeted by Lombardi McCollum, M.D. Well, and his people, who are working to preserve the sum of human knowledge that came before the nuclear holocaust that wiped out civilization. Carnegie managed to get Eel's Bible open only to discover that it was written in Braille and there is no way he can read it. Though he loses the Bible in the fight with Carnage, Ali remembers his entire constant by heart and can recount the words to Lombardi, who engagedly been writing everything down. Back in town, Carnegie is confronted by Claudia, who refused to translate the Braille for him, and alerts him that his quest to secure the book has led him to lose control of his city. After recounting the Bible in its entirety, Ali eventually dies, and the freshly printed Bible is placed among the shelf full of other holy books in the final scenes of The Book of Ali. Solara opts not to stay at the Alta Cruz sanctuary and takes Ali's sword as she returns home across the wasteland. Though The Book of Ali gives very little indication that Ali cannot see, it nevertheless pulls a shocking twist by revealing that he is blind. One of the things that make The Book of Ali an unrated 2010 sci-fi movie is that it's continued to push its concept further and further, and Ali blindness is just a meaningless twist. Brilliantly revealed in the scenes where Carnegie discovered the Bible is in Braille, the twist ending came about slowly as opposed to being movement that overemphasized itself, and it's completely changed The Book of Ali's story. Unlike many other movie twists that make us rewatch unnecessarily, the reveal of Ali's blindness makes The Book of Ali more compelling experience as on second viewing. Ali's blindness also makes him more dynamic because his very existence becomes symbolic. Throughout the movie, Ali exposes the power and importance of faith, and though he never uses the exact word, faith has always been described as a blind belief. Ali is the living embodiment of faith because he allows himself to be led by the higher power and adventure that would normally be impossible for someone who is visually impaired. Action movie where the main character dies are rare, but The Book of Ali ending is made better because Ali doesn't survive. Instead of giving him all the guns blazing final, that would have tipped the movie into Sailor's territory. Alice Moore's and stubble that is appropriate for a character who is an action horror hero by choice. Alice that the end of the book of Ali is almost necessity because it's reflect element of the Bible and the many other figure who also met their ends in pursuit of faith. The gunshot wounds Ali suffered from carnage earlier in the movie led to his death, but not before he can impart his knowledge of the Bible to Lombardi. Having made the ultimate sacrifice, Ali tried his life to protect the religion he holds dear, and he married Christine and Mysterious, who would later become saints in some dimensions. The power of sacrifice is one of the central tenets of the most religions, but it's especially important in Christianity when considering the story of Jesus and his death in the New Testament, something the hero journey in the Book of Ali mirrors. Despite not being a critical success, The Book of Ali is anything but a disposable blockbuster with no substance. Nearly every aspect of the story serves more larger purpose in the grand scheme of things, and the plot is rich with meaning. The Book of Ali to make it clear in the end of the Christianity isn't the sole specific message that is to be taken away from the story, because the newly printed Bible take its place among other holy books. Instead, the Book of Ali is ultimately about the power of ideas and it's how they can be wielded for good and bad purpose. Carnage wanted to use the Bible as a means of controlling the minds of those around him, while Lombardi and Ali were keepers of knowledge who only wanted to benefit humanity. Ironically, Ali cryptically suggests in the voiceover that the apocalyptic war was fought over religion, which makes his mission all the more imperative. In the end, the Book of Ali doesn't endorse a religion over another, but instead warns of the power of such powerful belief and shows how they can be intense good as well and unfathomable evil that can spring from the very same well of ideas. The Book of Ali 2 has been a cult success as far as post-apocalyptic movies ago, with many fans hoping for the sequel 3 also. While there are currently no plans for the Book of Ali 3, there is another project that will extend the manifesting story. A Book of Ali prequel series starring John Boyega is currently in development, with the screenwriter Gary Whitta set to return. The Book of Ali prequel shown in still in the development with the studio Alcon Television Entertainment behind the project. It's currently unknown which network or streaming service is the series will arrive on, as it's currently being shopped or various different potential buyers. The source was announced in January 2024, and new has been scarce in the time since. While there are very few details, it is known that the Whitta plans and Boyega's to star as a younger version of Ali. Given the time frame of the 2010s movie, it is entirely impossible that the show will include the apocalypse that occurred before the Book of Ali being shown. How the character in the movie become the heroes and villains seen in the original film, there is also a chance, of course, that is a prequel series in a success that Book of Ali 2 could. And as soon as you hear the title, you can probably guess what kind of film the Book of Ali 2 is going to be. Yes, it is the story about a man named Ali and who is alone. One of the films who has a book, it's also about the Bible, which is the case, seems to provide not a set of belief but simply the hope that humanity has a future. The film play out in a proposed apocalyptic wasteland that will look familiar to fans of the Mad Max trilogy. Like the protagonist in those films, Ali must fight off a slew of lenses killer thieves and rapists who will, like Ali, have solved the nuclear holocaust that occurred 30 years earlier. Ali's mission gave to him by a voice in his head is to move west in the book, which is supposedly the last copy of Earth. And The themes of the film doesn't explore as deeply as it might. The Book of Ellie 2 is an old-fashioned western dressed up in the protagonist rig. Ellie is the main with no name who assembled into backwater bog in search of water, came to face to face with the evil in a form of carnates. So, Newbill daughter Solara Milliken is the real some illusion here to be the biblical story of hero and his daughter. So this is the complete review of the movie. So if you guys like it, then don't forget to subscribe our channel and let us know in a comment section how this review is. So thank you very much for joining us till the end of the video. Keep loving, keep watching. Till then, take care. We will meet soon in my next video. Thank you very much.